What's up, everybody? This is Fitty.
And I'm Izzy.
And this is How We Talk.
Again.
Again what?
Another show.
Oh,
yeah. This guy.
Go ahead, man, because I need to adjust this mic. I forgot to do
All
this
right,
before we started recording.
In studio, we got two guests. When was the last time we had two guests?
The last time we had two guests was probably Troquera B and Laura.
And Laura.
I think so,
That's
yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
So here we have David and Luis.
David Rodriguez and Luis Molina.
Yes, thank you guys for having us.
Oh, thank see, you. I'm not good at that.
What?
I just knew their first names.
Oh, yeah.
That's good. That was
I like
good.
To do, I like to learn people's full name. Because it just helps me out when later on, you know, and then I like to say it 3 or 4 times, you know. So when yeah. when I get introduced to someone, you might hear me say like, oh, is that right, Luis? Oh, thanks, Luis. Oh, that's a nice story, Luis.
Oh, so then the
next
remember.
Yeah, helps me remember. So then that's the good. Next, he might think, oh, he's probably remember like, oh, that was the guy, the weirdo that says everything 3 times.
Yeah, he's
you know what I mean?
What are those, the people that, OCD?
He has OCD, yeah, OCD.
They're not weirdos, man.
No.
They're not weirdos, man.
No, we're obsessive. That's it.
They're not weirdos, man. No, just kidding.
Oh, I see what he was doing there. Yeah, I saw what he was doing there.
Making you remember.
So what? You asked me how I know Luis. Okay. So me and Luis, we used to play soccer together. San Gabriel Valley. Yeah. That's where we grew up. Yeah, yeah,
nice.
Yeah. So we played, the first time I ever played with you was with
Rapids,
right?
Rapids, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, the Green Monster.
Yeah.
That was cool. Those are some good old days. Yeah. I met a lot of my friends that I still know today from soccer. I still
it seem weird,
we might,
but I want to turn myself up. Sorry.
We may not hang out as much.
But we're still family.
Yeah. We right. get, you know, right where we left off, you know, right. pick it right back up. Yeah. And that's pretty cool. That's special.
Those are good friends. I just read something about that. Those are good friends where if you don't see each other for a while, you don't talk to each other for a while, but then you see each other, it's like you left off.
Yeah.
You pick up where you left
pick
off.
Pick up where you left off, yeah. Those are good. Special.
Good people.
I have a question.
Yes, sir.
Are you guys play good or
soccer?
Yeah.
No. That's why we're doing podcasts right now. No. You know what? But that's a good question because I did want to talk and Luis and I've never asked you about this and maybe because it was back when it happened it was too soon, you know. But Luis was really good. To me Luis was a stud. You know, he was going places to my eyes, right? When I used to play with Luis. So, this guy got injured. And I don't even remember how he got injured, but I remember visiting him in the hospital, broken leg and all that. I don't think you ever recovered fully from that. I think you might have tried to come back and play.
No, I never.
Came back to play, huh?
I don't have another chance.
You didn't come back from that injury?
No.
Oh, man.
I actually tore my 4 ligaments and I tore the arterial artery, the one that's connected to your heart. I tore that one. My bones just. Did a twisty and a hyperextension, so I was in pretty bad shape.
Damn.
Just to say, you know, in a short story, I was going to die.
Wow.
Yeah.
It was pretty bad.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. Really bad. So I didn't attempt to come back. I mean, I hated the sport for many years, and that's what led me to Sobrevivientes, you know?
How did that lead you to Sobrevivientes?
Because
first, what is Sobrevivientes?
Well, Sobrevivientes is a group. It's survivors in English. It's a rap group, a reggaeton group. But we only do lyrics for church.
Okay,
you know, nice. I've been a musician all my life. So after this accident, I found myself in a deep hole. You know, I hated a lot of things. I hated soccer. I hated the people around me because when you go from 100 to zero, it's really tough mentally and physically, you know?
Yeah.
Well, especially physically because you can't move. So that makes you a really angry person and depressive person, you know? And I think a lot of people don't accept it, but I was able to accept it many years later that I was becoming this sour person.
Yeah.
So I remember my uncle, he passed away, but he saw me, so this is not like you. Because you know me, I was been hyper, yeah. I was been, you know, in a good mood, but I was always angry, you know. And he said, you know what, he's like, you can't live your life like this. And he's like, you need to go to Spain, because my favorite group, my favorite team is Real Madrid.
Yeah.
So he's like, you have to go to El Bernabeu. You have to go liberate yourself. And at the moment, I understand what he was talking about. But I said to myself, no, I'm not going to a place that, you know, soccer's done, you know.
Yeah.
It was taken away from me. And like, I loved it so much. It was like my drug, you know. So I did listen to my uncle. I ended up going to Spain. I went to Madrid. I went to the field with a couple friends after we graduated from college. And when I got to the field, man, like, as soon as I stepped, the first time I ever stepped into grass, into, you know, I just started crying.
Wow.
Like a baby.
Yeah.
Just let go, you know? Yeah. I just cried. And my friends were like very supportive.
Mm-hmm.
But I nobody knew what I was crying, you know? They had been through the process of me getting back, but just that liberated me, you know? They did a beautiful thing, you know, where they come out,
yeah,
the little tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
They said, hey, just go down and come up. So, okay, cool. Went down, I came up, and they're like, oh, Luis Molina, el mejor goleador del mundo, blah, blah, guatemalteco, blah, blah, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
So they made a big old scene, and everybody started clapping, you know? Yeah, and I was like, oh, like, you know, it liberated me.
Yeah.
So I became back to being me with, some physical limitations, but I'm back. You know, I'm able to run, I'm able to enjoy life and see it in the bright side. So, mm-hmm. Sobreviventes is actually survivors. You know, it was my survival from death, because I almost passed away.
Yeah.
And survive from being an ugly person, being a person of depression. Negative, you know. So I survived to things, and I always attributed to God. You know, God was there.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think without him, I could have never done it. So my family, friends, you know, like Fitty, that was there. But that's what the group was made out of. Out of this, you know, everybody's a survivor. You have your story. Mm-hmm. You have your story.
Yeah.
He has his story. And the whole world has his story.
Yeah.
And we're all survivors.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, so that's what we decided to name the group. Sobrevivientes.
There you
go. Is it comprised of other people that have survival stories as well?
Yeah. My brother. My brother actually was born good, okay. But then he developed meningitis after he was born. So he has 9 operations on his head, and he's the miracle kid in Guatemala. We're from Guatemala.
Mm-hmm.
So he's the miracle kid. He's the only kid that actually survived that and another, I forgot the name of the other disease, but it makes your head grow and eventually they die.
Mm.
So he survived that, you know, and then there was 2 more people that were in it, and they have their own story, yeah.
Nice.
Wow. I didn't even know that about Doug. I mean, I'm assuming you're talking about Doug.
Yeah.
Okay. Because Herms wasn't in the Sobrevivientes, was he?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just Doug, yeah. Shout out to my brother, Doug.
And Herms.
And Herms.
Yeah. Okay. Damn. Well, yeah, see, I didn't know about all that. I just, Sobrevivientes, I don't know. I just thought, I guess it was the name of the band, but I never asked you about it. Yeah. I was waiting for the podcast.
Yeah, there you go. And that's how I met David.
Yeah.
You know? Being in church, you know, you meet a lot of people, but David is genuine. You know, it's just somebody that, like you said, like I see you today. I might not have seen you from 10 years ago, and it's just what you pick off.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like family. And David's somebody that I work with a lot. And, you know, he's a very talented person. He's very patient. He's always about the people.
Yeah.
And it's kind of hard to find somebody that always puts himself second in order to make you first, you know, and that's who David is and who he stands for. And that's why we're going to be here talking about this project that he's been developing for a couple of years now.
And David, you're also a musician?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I play guitar, and I'm one of the singers of my band, too. Yeah.
Genesis. Or in Spanish, we say?
Genesis. Genesis, the first book of the Bible.
Yep.
And also, it's a story about that, too, right? I think, like, people like me and Luis, that are joining these kind of projects, it's because God do something for us and we want to share it, you know, with more people.
Right.
And for me, always like rock, and I have a lot of friends that we play rock and drugs, alcohol, and everything. And
that rock star life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of. And I have an accident, and I was drunk, and they take me to the hospital. So my car was all crashed.
Yeah.
They had to open it from top. So
jaws of life.
Yeah, to take me out. And doctors saying that I'm not going to be able to walk anymore. And I was on the hospital for like 2 weeks, like no moving at all.
Wow.
And I'm still here. And I remember after I recovered from my accident, it was my friend's birthday,
mm-hmm.
and we went to, I was still like, you know, like with muletas and
crutches.
Yeah. And we went to a nightclub,
mm-hmm.
and I got drunk again. I was like, man.
Back at it.
Yeah.
back at it.
And you know what happened to me? When I went to court, that you told me, you know what? You need to go to jail.
Yeah.
You need to go to jail for a couple of days to learn your lesson. And they give me like 9 days.
Yeah.
So I went there for, I think I went on Friday and I got out on Monday. I think they come
for the weekend.
Yeah. Having my weekend vacations.
Yeah.
And when I was there is when I was like, man, I don't want this for me.
Yeah.
I don't really want this for me. You don't know if it's day or it's night. You know, you're just there and you know, there are some pay phones mm-hmm. and then you ask them what time is it right now.
Yeah.
So that's the way you know. And it was like, I don't have a really bad experience there because I make a lot of friends there.
Yeah.
But just to be there is like, it was like, nah, I don't want this for me.
Yeah. Being told where to go, what to do at a certain time, all that.
Yeah. You know, and I'm always believing God, but I've never been like a church boy, you know?
Yeah.
I remember I liked it when I was kid, but not like going, you know, I just go mass for quinceañeras or, you know,
for and Christmas and Easter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And when I was there, I was praying. I was telling God, you know what? When I get out from here, I'm gonna change. Mm-hmm. I wanna change. But I need your help. I need your help because I don't wanna be upside and feel free and not do anything and keep the same way. You know?
Go back at it, yeah.
Yeah, and believe me or not, God listened to us. And I was released on Monday. By Tuesday, my friend from high school, he called me, We went to the church and we talked with like Madre Graciela, una monjita.
Mm-hmm.
She said, it's fine. We want to play rock. So come and sing and play the guitar. Like, and I was like, wow, we want to play rock in the church?
Yeah.
So yeah, we talked to her already. I was like, nah. It was like, with the band, we had like 15 years.
Yeah.
15 years ago, it was, today is more like common,
mm-hmm.
but now in that time.
Yeah.
And I was like, really? Rock? Say yeah, well, okay, let's go. And I was thinking, wow, God really listened to me and put me in that place to change.
Yeah.
And I went there, and when I, the first time when I walked to the, to, it was a large hall from church, I had a feeling like, well, that's, here's where I belong.
Yeah.
And I started there, we started with a band, and then I'm getting involved to the youth group, and I'm still there, man.
Yeah, doing your thing.
Yeah.
And then, so when did Genesis come in?
It's came in when my friend called me.
Mm-hmm.
So when I started with Genesis, in the day that when he called me to go to church.
Oh, so this band was already around.
No.
You joined
started.
It? Oh, you started this started. Band. Okay.
You know, my friend called me and say, oh, come. We already talked to her because they're like starting the band.
Yeah.
And we started with Genesis and we named it Genesis because it was like a beginning.
Yeah.
You know, Genesis is the beginning mm-hmm. of
first
everything.
First book of the Bible.
Yeah. And it was a beginning for us, for me.
Yeah.
For my friends too. They have their own stories too. And it was a new beginning for us, a new life to change, to be different, you know?
So Genesis has been around for a while.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah. So there is some people that go.
Right.
They put their part and they go. But right now, we have like we're three of the regionals. And two, they've been there for a while.
Yeah.
And it's a girl that is a singer. And he's with us for about 5 years already.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Nice.
Yep.
And then, so most of the time you guys just perform at church events? Is that?
Mostly, yeah. In some fairs also. Sometimes they call us to go on to fair from church.
Mm-hmm.
But mostly, yeah. We do concerts. And, we start a tour, a rock Catholico tour. And then after that, my friend here have an idea to make another tour, but with all kind of music.
Mm-hmm.
And we work on that and we make it happen, you know.
Is that that's when you brought in the little reggaeton? Bit of reggaeton with some of that rock.
Yeah. See, I wanna emphasize something though. I mean, think about rock in church, right?
Yeah.
You know, no.
Well, yeah. Because most of the time we think hard rock, like, you know, devil worshiping stuff, right? That's right. What we think. Right?
But they play hard.
Yeah. Oh, okay. You
know? Yeah, they play hard.
Headbanging, all that.
But the thing is this though, like, what we emphasize is the lyrics. You know, because a lot of people think about church, okay, oh, church, you have to be holy, you can't be yourself. And it goes back to what we were talking about earlier. You have to be yourself. You have to be original. I mean, you can't be church and be a poser, like, oh, you know, no, that's not who we are.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's not what the Bible says. It says, come as you are.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, and it's this misperception from people that think that, oh, I got to change who I am.
Yeah.
No, maybe not who you are, but maybe the habits that might be causing some kind of problems in your, you know, if you're an alcoholic, I'm sure your wife and kids might be suffering, if that's the case, you know. Everybody has their demons, you know. But what I want to emphasize is that reggaeton was not accepted, and I'm pretty sure that, you know, but we started this tour, and a diverse tour, because me and David always had the idea of uniting, you know, bring people in, give people a chance, which is kind of hard, because in an environment like that, everybody wants to stand out, you know, still the mundane goes into it.
Yeah.
But we had a vision of uniting people, giving people a chance. And the tour has been going on for about maybe 7 years.
Yeah.
The one that we started,
yeah.
You know, I haven't been in the game for a while, but David's been there, and he's taken off to like great things, like his purpose, you know, his event. So
let's talk about this event right here. I did see last year. I noticed last year you were mostly, were you the headlining the event, the band was a headline.
Yes.
Yeah, because I saw a lot of the Genesis, but I see that you guys have a concert, and we'll say it in Spanish because that's how it says it here.
Mm-hmm. Want me to read it?
I'm just kidding. Let's let Israel read it.
Where am I reading?
We're going to go right here. Turn it over.
Right, juguete, una sonrisa.
Yeah. There it is. There it is.
That means.
Yeah, what does that mean?
A toy, a smile.
Yeah.
Right?
Good.
One toy, one smile.
He's a poser. He says he doesn't know Spanish. He knows Spanish.
I'm just kidding.
So it's a concierto de caridad, right? Un juguete de una sonrisa, 2018, compartiendo el amor de Dios. This is going to be an event, November 17. So November 17th. Mm. Tell us a little bit about this. I know it's going to be somewhat of a toy drive, right?
Yes. So this project is being for... This is going to be the fifth year. So 5 years we're doing this. And it starts it was the 10 years anniversary for my band. And we're thinking and do something different, you know, to celebrate.
Yeah.
And we got to, you know, we always like to help, because when we leave, I'm coming from Mexico.
Yeah.
And I see a lot of people there. I mean, I have a good, kind of good life. It was not bad. But I know a lot of people, they really need help.
Mm-hmm.
And we are like, well, probably we can do something about it, you know?
Yeah.
And then we become with this idea to collect toys during the concert. So the entrance, you bring a new toy. Mm-hmm. And then we have it's a monjita, mm-hmm. una religiosa.
Nun.
A nun, mm-hmm. yeah. Oh, the movie.
Oh, that's right. I want to see that movie. I forgot about that. Did you guys see it already?
Not yet.
Oh, okay. No, I want to see it too. But yeah, so he's always with us.
Mm-hmm.
And they have another nuns on Tijuana.
Mm-hmm.
And they teach them about God. And they know which the people that really need help.
Right.
Mm. Right?
Right.
And then we talk with her. And she said, well, it's a good idea. So we start... For the first concert, we collect about 200 toys.
Mm-hmm.
And we went to Tijuana, and we gave the toys on by Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
Even. And we think we can do more, you know? And it was one day, just Monday. I mean, just Sunday. And just the kids just go to the house of the nuns.
Yeah.
And they pick out the toy. That's it, right? So next year... We see, let's be, you know, working more, and mm-hmm. let's try to do something better. So next year we planning to go 2 days, Saturday and Sunday, and we wanted to make like a big posada, like a full posada for them. So we got some people the donate money to pay the tamales, to pay the champurrado, piñatas. And we were able to make the posada for mm-hmm. them, and then also the toys, and also the nun, she has a lot of donations
mm-hmm.
from King Taco.
Oh yeah, shout out to King Taco.
Yeah, they give you like rice, beans, all of that.
Yeah,
and we also give food for the parents. So we've been growing. Last year, I think we collect about 600 toys.
Wow,
600 toys in and a lot of food.
So the toys is that's the entry fee for the concert and stuff.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, that's smart.
And also, we'll still collect toys from people that are not able to go to the concert.
Donations.
Donation. They call us, and there's now is a lot of people involved.
Mm-hmm.
This project started just with the band and the youth group from our church,
mm-hmm.
but now there's a lot of more people from the community.
That it's a huge event now.
That help us.
That's cool.
And the collections, they help us, and the donations. Some of them they move it by their own with their friends collecting money.
Mm. Yeah.
In their work, they put a box. You know.
Yeah.
And this been growing, and it's good. You know, because we've been helping a lot of people, and we wanna make a smile on a kid on Christmas. You know?
Yeah.
When you're a kid, you don't care about too many things. You want a toy.
You want a toy. Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And we also bring some blankets. From some clothes,
mm-hmm.
In last year we have an idea to, we call it adopt a family.
Okay.
And that's mean if you adopt one family, you're gonna buy a individual present for each member of the family, and also you wanna pay for their Christmas dinner.
Oh wow.
Yeah, and our plan was 4 families because it wanna be the first time,
mm-hmm.
and then. People that can be asking, and we adopt 8 families last year. And then we went there, we give all the presents, and also we talk with some restaurant over there. So we pay the food, and they deliver it on the 24th of December to them. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, this year we want to adopt like 13 families. So we're working on it right now, so I hope we can make it. I hope we can make more, you know?
Yeah.
You never know. So,
well, that's what we're here to help out and promote as much as we can. So,
yeah, thank you.
It sounds like they have a lot of people helping you out, a lot of sponsors, which is very good. I mean, so something like this is what you need is a lot of the sponsors, right?
Yeah.
It's been going on for 10 years.
The project 5 years.
5 years. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
5 years, but that's a good amount of time to be 5 years to keep going, and it sounds like it's growing and getting bigger.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And every year, like, we're trying to do something better.
Uh-huh.
And also, I forgot to mention it, but so what we do on Saturday, we go there, we make the posada for them, and we give the toys away. And Sunday, we go to visit the families that were adopted. And then after that, we went to one of the communities that really need help. And then we just park in the street.
Mm-hmm.
We put all the toys and we have some of the food. You know, we had like a package.
Yeah.
With rice, beans, oil, you know, a lot of things.
Yeah, like real food, right?
And then people start coming down and people there, you know, the neighbors, they say, hey, they're giving toys. And there's a lot of people going there. And it's really, for us, it's touched us a lot.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
To see all of the things. And for me, I have a daughter, 13 years old, and she's always go with me.
Yeah.
And for me, it's like teaching her something,
yeah.
You know?
100%.
And she's really involved, and she's really like it, and she's just waiting for the day, you know? And like my daughter is a lot of boys and girls from the youth group. They mm-hmm. really like it.
Yeah.
And like you say, we have a lot of sponsors. But we need more, you know? We want to do more. We have a lot of sponsors, but there is people like you, like Luis, from the community. We don't have, like, you know, big companies,
mm-hmm.
which is King Taco.
Yeah.
But they help the nuns.
Mm-hmm.
But nuns, they save some of whatever they got for, mm-hmm. for us.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a cool thing, man. I mean, I personally want to say that, you know, I was born in Guatemala. You know, my parents were migrated over here. But I remember as a kid, you know, I always wanted a soccer ball. And over there, the plastic ones. I don't know if you guys remember those. Plastic ball, right? And I never got one, you know?
Yeah.
And it's just like, thinking back, like, I'm like, dude, when things I wanted as a kid, like, sometimes my parents couldn't.
Right.
Yeah. It's a reality of it, you know? And then you come to the States, and then you're so blessed. And then my kid's three now, and he's so spoiled. And I just sit and look at him. And it's like, man, you're so blessed, you know?
Yeah.
And we can't forget, like, where we came from, you know? And, I mean, if I would have got the soccer ball when I was 7, 6, I think I would have had a big old smile on my head, on my face, you know?
Right.
So we started to think about our countries, you know? You take them toys. It's just like, you make this kid's life.
Yeah.
You know? And that's what it's about, you know? That's what being a community is about, you know? I mean, yeah, you go to church and, you know, you go to the building, but the actions are outside the building.
Yeah.
It's not what you do in the building. It's outside, you know?
Right.
And this is something that we've been a part of since the beginning. And David actually is taking me out of retirement.
You're bringing back the band back
together.
Bringing
me back together, yeah. So it's cool, you know. It's you know, it's keeping in touch with what we've done, what we stand for, and thanks to you guys, we're here to promote, and the people that are hearing and listening. You don't have to go to church if you don't want to, but if you want to change somebody's life or make a kid smile, let us know. We'll pick up the toy.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you want to see like what we do in church on those concerts, go. It's not like you're saying before, no, it's not boring. It's not like a lot of people that think the church is boring.
Yeah.
And like Luis was saying, they think we need to change. We don't need to change what we are. If you're a happy person, you can be a happy person, but you can also go in church, you know?
Yeah.
I have a lot of mistakes, and I've been there for a long time ago, but I still have a lot of mistakes, and nobody's perfect.
Yeah.
In what we do, when the Luis do when his band and the other people that are gonna participate, it's really nice. It's really nice. Is you're not gonna see the difference between those groups to the whatever group, you know?
Yeah.
Right. It's just the lyrics and it's a good message.
So if you want some reggaeton, we'll be there. If you want some rock and español, we'll be there.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Let's talk a little bit about the bands that are going to be there. So you got Sobre Vivientes, which is your band.
Yeah.
And that's a reggaeton-based band.
Reggaeton, and then we start doing some merengue.
Okay.
Yeah, so merengue, reggaeton. And then some electro reggaeton.
Yeah.
So everything has a tone at the end.
You said that he brought you back. Have you not performed in a while?
It's been, well, I got married and then everything changes, right?
Oh, yeah.
Good, positive changes.
Well, the positive changes.
Positive
changes. You have to give up some things, you know. But
she might be watching.
Yeah, she will be watching. Love you, babe. So it's been about 4 years since I've been on a stage. So,
yeah. It's going to be different, huh?
So, I'm trying to prepare and feel comfortable.
They say it's like riding a bike, though, right?
Yeah.
Get right back on it.
Yeah.
You'll be good.
We'll find out.
You used to do radio.
Yeah.
Is this something somewhat similar, this setup here?
it feels like home, to be honest.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm really excited inside of me. I'm really excited to be here. I mean, it's the mics, you know, the chords, and just having to talk and, you know, just the topic itself.
Nice.
But yeah, it brings me home. Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Nice. What about
so if you guys need no, just kidding.
the co-host? Yeah. We'll call you in anytime he's out on vacation or something. Yeah. I'll give you a call. This one right here is GDY band.
Yeah, they play like cumbia.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they play really good too. So the full name of the band is Guerreros de Yahvé.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Guerreros de
Yahvé.
Yahvé. Where's that at?
Yahvé means Dios. You know?
Oh.
The key?
Oh, I got it.
No.
No?
Well, God is the key, so yeah. Kind of.
All right, so that's cumbias?
Yeah, cumbias.
And then you got Miguel Ochoa.
Miguel Ochoa, he's been for a while, right?
He's been a game probably my age. No, I'm just kidding. Not for a long time. He's been there for a while.
Yeah, he plays kind of like a lot.
Solo artist, obviously.
Yes, and he's a lot of like different styles.
Mm-hmm.
Different, yeah.
And then you have, of course, Hennessy's.
Mm-hmm.
And not the liquor Hennessy's. But the band, Hennessy.
Yes.
All right. Right.
Hey, but both are very, very contagious, though. You know.
Yeah.
Very strong.
Yeah, very strong.
They're very rock and roll.
Yeah.
And also, we're gonna have a play. There is a group that's gonna perform a play.
Okay.
The name is El Rey Busca un Tesoro.
Is that in here?
The king's looking for a treasure.
Is
right. Oh, right here.
Yeah.
En vivo la obra de teatro El Rey Busca un Tesoro.
Tesoro.
Sorry, I'm dyslexic. All right. So, go ahead. You're gonna say something. I'm sorry.
No, I was gonna talk about the CD. All these musics. What is on YouTube? they could find it on YouTube as well?
Yes.
Is there music videos or is it just music?
Yeah, music videos, some live concerts.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Some practice records. So we have a lot of videos on there. Yeah.
Well, what is it that you're that like some of your goals that you want to do, and not so much with the because I know this right here, you're gonna want to continue this for as long as you can.
Yeah, definitely.
Hennessy's Genesis, is this something that you're going to be doing like forever or just kind of stick to this, or is this something else that you want to branch out to with the band?
Well,
like a bigger stage. Have you ever thought of that?
We talk about that. There is really big concerts on around here in LA or
Southern California.
Yeah, there's a big concert like those Congress for. There's a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
In before it was like we wanna do something, you know, big.
Right.
Like a human being, you always think like do something big, like people can see you, you know.
Yeah.
But now we think it's for us just communicate the message.
Mm.
What we got. So all the songs that we wrote and everything is it has something for us, something about our experiences,
mm-hmm.
and something that we want to tell the kids or whatever is going to listen, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we like want to do, you know. More like, well, if it's something big come out, so it's good.
Yeah.
You know, but we're not like really stress about that. So
yeah.
If it takes you there. Yeah.
Okay.
You know, whatever God we're gonna put us to play, so we wanna be there. You know.
Okay. How many albums do you guys have?
One.
One album. How many songs?
I think there are 10.
12 songs.
12 songs.
There you go.
Yeah. It's been hard. Now it's more easy
mm-hmm.
to record a CD.
These are all original tracks, right?
Yes.
That's our friend.
Two covers from some Catholic music,
mm-hmm.
mm.
but most of them are us.
Yeah. I mean, when you guys perform live, do you guys perform the whole album, or do you guys do a lot of traditional, you know, Catholic songs that you would hear, you know, like covers?
Yeah, we usually play more from our music.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And now we have a lot of more, so we planning to record another CD. And also we have another covers, mm-hmm. but we always like to promote our music.
Yeah.
But we also play some covers, you know, that people know the songs.
Yeah.
So yeah.
You guys ever do a little mashup, the Sobrevivientes and?
Well, see, that's what I was gonna get to right now, because I've been begging this guy to do a collaboration with me for a long time.
That'd be awesome,
you know,
man.
Some also Motley type thing, you
exactly.
know, like you know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But we haven't got around to do it, so hopefully now that it's easier.
Yeah, now that you're back in the game.
He's bringing me back, right?
Are you planning to stay out of retirement, or is this just for like an event or something like that?
You know what, dude? I've been thinking about that. You know, after the call, I got a few calls, you know, and it kind of started like just randomly just started bringing it back. And I'm
maybe
thinking,
it's not random, man.
Yeah, you know, it's faith, you know.
Right.
But I, as of now, I don't know. But if it takes me, I mean, I would love to be back. I mean. You know, he's being modest. He's done big events, you know, and we've done small events, you know, thousands of people, 10 people, you know, it doesn't matter the quantity of the people. But what I always loved about this guy is his humbleness,
mm-hmm.
you know, he's always been willing to do what he needs to do to send a message. So he's never asked for a big stage. He's had them, but he's always done it for what he believes in. And that's what. You know, essence, what being a,
what it's all about. Yeah,
it's all about, yeah.
The main, so we'll see. The main message.
Actually, I have a CD that's already art written. Like the you know, everything's done. All I have to do is record it.
Mm.
There you go.
Yeah. So maybe I'll finish it. 12.
12 tracks.
12 tracks. It's all original.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And who does all the music?
This old producer I had in Anaheim.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he does all the. Well, me and him did it together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lyrics, ito.
Lyrics myself.
Okay.
But the music, I told him what to do, and yeah. So.
And that's reggaeton.
It's reggaeton, merengue, electro reggaeton, Euro reggaeton.
Yeah.
So it's a mixture of everything. Yeah.
Yeah. Doug's still playing in there?
He has a lot of good songs there too. So yeah. He just needs to record them. So maybe this is a calling, you know?
That's it. This is it. And who writes the songs for Genesis? Because you're the lead singer. So that means you have to probably have to write some of them.
I wrote some. Yeah. And there is some other members that have some good
just a big ideas. Collaboration.
Yeah. And actually it's like we call it like, we don't say I do it because I have an idea or something and I bring it to the practice and like all of us put something and it's our song, you know. I do it.
So everybody collabs.
Yes.
But music is the essence of the soul, man.
Yeah.
You know? In all languages, all languages.
It is in all languages.
You used to sing.
I did. I used to sing.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, back in the day. You know, in junior high, I was in choir.
Oh, there you go.
I had one solo. I'll knock it out one day.
It was so low.
It was so low.
No one heard it. Yeah.
It was pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think so.
I mean, we might talk later.
My mom told me shoot.
Might bring you out of retirement.
You're my mom.
Oh, let's do it.
Biggest fan. Oh, yeah.
Bring him here, man. Like 5 minutes from here.
Do you really?
Yeah.
That's right. You said you live down the street.
Yeah.
And is your studio at your home?
Yes. I make like my garage.
Yeah.
I work in
the Oh, man. We're going to have to talk because I want to do that here.
Yeah.
I'm gonna close this thing up, put some walls up here, make it a studio.
We'll help you. I have a studio at home too.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? I haven't been to your place.
I never used.
Huh?
I never used it. It's just there.
The studio?
Yeah.
Oh, what a waste.
What a waste of a studio.
What a waste.
Start a podcast.
Yeah, you should start a podcast.
Hey.
Why not?
Hey. The lights are going on.
Seriously. I should have want to do something like that too with some other leaders from different
bands. A podcast?
Yes.
Or a talk radio?
Like talk about God, about Bible, about message.
Yeah.
And play some like live songs, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's something that was in my head. So
you know, I encourage you to do that because other than actually getting like buying the stuff and all the stuff, like that's the easy stuff because you could just throw a card on it and buy it all and whatever, put it together. But it's this right here is what you can't purchase. You can't purchase a conversation. You know, like 1 hour, you sit down with somebody 1 hour, 2 hours, and you guys actually talk about something meaningful and something that you guys are passionate about. That you can't pay for. You know, that's the art, the talent right there.
That's one thing that I love about this. Not that I didn't have a life before, but dude, we've met so much people. We've been in contact with so much people. We learned so much things. And now it's like, oh, do you know anyone that does? No, but remember so-and-so and we can get in contact with this. We can get in contact.
Yeah.
We meet all these people, you know, and then if not that, then okay, let's talk about the advice that we've gotten or just the stories that we've heard. You know, all the stuff that we get to take away from it, it's awesome. Yeah. And then it's in video format, so people can watch it.
You get to share it with everybody else, you know, so that's cool.
So keep in touch with how we talk.
That's right.
Keep it every week.
Podcast.
Yeah.
And to be honest, being here today and see how you guys do it, and it's made me more clue how to go, you know. I've been on the show when Luis was on the radio for interviews, but I really never pay attention. I just go for the interview and I help them sometimes with the audio, right?
Yeah.
And the Congress and everything. But like today, it's make me like, oh, wow, it's really nice. Like you guys mentioned right now, like talking like, well, we don't know each other anymore, but it feels good. Like talking like a friend, like good conversation, like you're saying. I was nervous.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, oh, I don't know these guys. And
yeah.
I see some of the postcards that you guys have before.
Mm-hmm.
And I was, well, let's see how it's going. But it made me feel really comfortable.
Yeah.
And it's really nice. Congratulations, guys.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate that. And it's like I said, if you take away these microphones and the headphones, that's all it is. It's just, four guys talking in a coffee shop, you know?
And you know how you said, like, you're paying attention how we do it? We don't even know how to do it. We just did it. Googled a lot of it. We YouTubed a lot of it. And even still, it might not be the proper way, but we do it and it's done. And it's, you know, people watching wouldn't know the difference. And they also wouldn't know what goes into it. You know, when we shut down here and then, now it's editing and all his research and stuff, you know, But there's a lot that goes into it. But we do it because we love it.
Yeah, it's fun.
It's fun.
You know, it's cool that you guys are networking like that because you guys are helping people.
Yeah,
and see, that's what it's about, man. Yeah. I mean, like I said, you don't have to be in the building to do things. But when you build, you know, you build somebody's character or you bring them out and help them out in a certain way where it's a positive impact, then you're doing something. Yeah. You know, you do something for the community. And the more people that we have like that, the better our society can be.
Yeah. And that's what it's all about, like
you said.
That's
what he wanted to do originally. So that's what we're setting out to do, is for the community.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, thanks a lot, guys, for coming out here. Any messages that you guys want to talk about the show? Last plug?
Well, I want to invite everybody that can, that wants to make it. It's November 17th. It's going to be in San Ignacio Loyola, which is over there in Highland Park. And if you can't make the event, we encourage you to, you know, make somebody smile, you know, a kid smile in Christmas. You know, all it takes is a $5 toy, a $2 toy, whatever you want. You know, get in contact with our leaders here at How We Talk Podcast, and we could set up a pickup. Or, you know, David and I will be available to pick it up at your home if you want to be part of it. You know, it's something small at a small scale, but we're doing something big for somebody that's going to be smiling that day.
Yeah, and so help us to help. And this Christmas, believe me, if you do something for someone on Christmas or any time, but mostly on Christmas, your Christmas is going to be different. It's going to be different. You will feel more full from inside. And that's why we feel when we start doing this. And my Christmas changed a lot.
Yeah.
Changed a lot. And you guys want to join us for Tijuana? Let's go, man.
Let's do it. That's on the 18th is Tijuana, right?
No, we're going
to
go.
Sunday, the following day, you guys go to Tijuana?
No, we went in December.
Oh, in December?
December.
Oh, okay.
Probably want to go, I think it's the 14th and 15th.
Yeah. Sure.
Probably in that.
So just David, before Christmas.
David, yeah, before Christmas. You want to invite him for the concert?
Yeah, live concert. The concert, right?
You guys can do a live podcast.
Get us on stage.
We can go live, huh?
Yeah, you can go live. Pegote La Radio is going to be there.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's going to be another where I used to be at.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Wait, you were on Guadalupe, right?
Yeah, first, and then went to Pegote Radio. Yeah.
What's the second one?
Pegote La Radio. It's our archdiocese for Los Angeles.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're probably going to be there, so you guys want to go there, so
you guys are make welcome. A podcast.
I was going to do a Spanish plug, but I think David, Mr. David could take care of the Spanish plug.
Oh, yeah?
Go ahead.
Right now. Pues sí, nos queremos invitar al concierto. Es el 17 de noviembre. Si quieren, como dijo Luis, no pueden ir y quieren donar juguetes o hacer su propio, like, con sus amigos, colectar dinero, también lo pueden hacer. Nos pueden contactar a nosotros o a ellos, al programa, y lo hacemos llegar a las familias. Si colectan dinero, lo que ustedes colecten, créanme que va a ser bien usado y no es de que no lo vamos a quedar, es para ayudar, porque pues es lo único que hacemos, no ganamos nada, sino solo la satisfacción de ver a un niño feliz, a una familia que pueda tener una Navidad mejor, uh-huh. ¿Verdad? Y so, este 17 de noviembre los esperamos y ojalá nos puedan acompañar y apoyarnos.
Well, también, they could check out your videos of the actual footage you have when you're gone.
Oh, yeah.
On Facebook.
Yeah. Okay.
On Facebook, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Tenemos videos. Los acabo de subir en la página de Genesis Rock Católico en Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Y también en YouTube, así estamos. Y están los videos de lo que hacemos cuando vamos.
Mm.
Y ahí pueden darse una idea de qué es lo que se hace, de lo que platicamos, en mirarlo ahí en video y ver si les gustaría apoyarnos.
There you go. Yeah, well, antes de que publique el video, voy a dar todos los datos de la página y todo. Vamos a ponerlos ahí para que toda la gente tenga, just right away click and then you're at the page.
Good. Nice. And also, acabo de hacer una page de un juguete, una sonrisa.
Oh, okay,
so para
perfect.
Que le den likes o...
¿En el Instagram o Facebook?
Facebook.
Okay.
Facebook.
Perfect.
We're all school.
Yeah. Also MySpace. Oh, no.
You guys remembered MySpace?
Yeah.
Everybody's like, that was like for the rock, for the artist. Before it was for music, for artists, and then it just it got spoiled with all the.
Yeah, MySpace was really good for like bands.
And yeah. That's what it was really for. It was actually made for DJs and for bands.
Yeah.
And then regular people like me joined and started creating our nice little page with the colors, and we started editing, and we spoiled it.
top 10.
Yeah. Oh, they got really nasty when it was like top 18.
Top 18.
People just put people, right? Just to put
them. Remember that? And they used to go, hey, that's my cousin. How come I'm not on your top 10? Remember that? Oh, I hated that question. How come I'm not on your top 10?
How come I'm your top 10?
Yeah, you turn it back on them because I'm not on yours. Oh, and then it goes back and forth. No, forget about it.
Crazy.
Well, I want to thank you guys really for coming out here and letting us know about the event, this wonderful event. I hope everybody does come out. Check it out, November 17th. It's a toy drive.
Gracias. Nah, just kidding. I was going to try.
And on that note.
And we have some presents.
Oh, let's announce this before we sign off. Go ahead.
Well, trajimos unos dos CDs de la banda de Genesis, por si les interesa o les gustaría tenerlo, y dos camisas, uno para hombre y otro para mujer, y pues aquí los dejo con ellos y a ellos sabrán cómo los regalan, si quieren hacer un...
Vamos a hacer una...
O algo.
We can do a... What did you say you wanted to do?
I don't remember.
Not a raffle.
No.
You wanted to give everybody.
Oh, that's a question.
Yeah, there you go.
That's a question if they get it right. You could do
that. We'll do something.
Yeah.
But so if you guys want to get your gear, your free gear, tune in to the show because we will be posting something at the very end, and the first people that that participate, will get the prize.
Actually, no. You should get the first person that answers this question. Where the event is and what date it is. The first person that answers that question.
Okay. There you go.
But it's for presents. So.
Oh, but it's just for one. The other ones, they could decide.
All right. Cool.
Hey, well, thank you guys. We'd like to appreciate your time and having us here. And you guys are doing a great thing. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it, guys.
Yeah. That's
thank
it, guys. See you later.
I'm Fitty.
I'm Izzy.
Luis.
Eleonce.
David.
We out.
Y tú sabes cómo va.